Significant figures are a way that we communicate numbers in a consistent way with each other. To allow us to see why this is important, let's take a look at how we might measure things a little bit differently. So when we talk about measuring, it's very important to think about what tool we're using to measure. For example, let's say that you are trying to measure something in your home. You could use a measuring cup. Perhaps this is a 1 cup measuring, or you could just use a cup out of your closet, out of your cabinet. One of these is going to measure better than the other. And both of them are going to measure worse than if you use a scientific measurement device. So, for example, you could have a graduated cylinder. Each of these devices is going to allow you to measure with a different way. Degree of precision. The 1 cup is going to be much better than the random cup out of your cabinet if you're trying to do a recipe. If you are trying to do measurements in science, you want to use a scientific device, such as a graduated cylinder. In other situations, you may have other items that you might want to use. The significant figures that we record for each of those is going to be a little bit different. With the graduated cylinder, we can record far more numbers accurately than we could with just a typical measuring cup or even, a cup from your cabinet. When we look at numbers that someone else has measured, then we are stuck with whatever they have written down. So let's say if somebody wrote 1 cup. That tells us something that different than if they wrote down 12.34 milliliters. There's a lot of different values that we can look at, and the number of significant figures is going to vary between them. When we talk about values that you measure, every value that you can appropriately record from the device is what is a significant figure. When it comes to something someone else has measured, then we have to take a look at the significant figure rules like they are in your textbook. This is where it becomes more important to take a look at how that number is recorded and use the way that it is recorded as an indicator of how well the person originally measured it. So it's very important to focus on the difference between these two ways of looking at it when we start looking at the significant figure rules and how they apply. It's going to be also very important for you to be able to count the number of significant figures and values that someone else has measured or in the ways that you have recorded your own values. For example, in this 1 cup, we have just one significant figure. That number one. The number one here is a significant figure. In the second example, all of the digits in that 12.34 are also significant figures. So we have one significant figure here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 significant figures in this value. Let's take a look at the number of significant figures in each of these measured values. In the first measured value, this initial zero is what we call a placeholder zero. It just tells us that we have a very small value here, 0.18 meters. The 1 and the 8 are both going to be significant values, significant figures. If we look on the second one, 1.03 kilograms. The 1 is going to be significant. The 0 is also going to be significant because it is between two non-zero digits, and the three is also going to be significant. So all three are significant figures. In this third one, these two zeros to start the number are not significant. They're just telling us this is a small value. The three is significant, and so are the zeros after it. If you think about it this way, you wouldn't even write those additional zeros in there unless they were significant. So we have three significant figures in this value. In this last one, 500 centimeters, these zeros just tell us that we have a large number, that the 5 isn't just 5, it's 500. So these are placeholder zeros. We have no way of knowing whether the person who actually wrote this measured it out to exactly 500 centimeters. So we have to assume that those values are not significant, that they are part of an estimate. So this value only has one significant figure. This is a little bit different when we look at scientific notation. Scientific notation is really helpful because the coefficient of the value is always going to have all of the significant figures. So in this case, all of these digits are always going to be significant that come before the multiplication sign, before the 10 to the whatever exponent. So in 2.18, 2, 1, and 8 are all significant values. They were measured originally. So this gives us three significant figures. In the second one, we have three significant figures again. And in the final one, we only have one significant figure because we only have one number in the coefficient.